to the start of our 2023 homecoming game festivities. Please, if you will, take your seats as we get ready to introduce our homecoming court. First, we would like to take a moment to thank our homecoming advisors and all the parents for your support of Garza's homecoming activities. Next, we would like to thank the Salas, the Chambers, BMW, and Ford for their wonderful vehicles for our homecoming parade. To begin the festivities tonight, we have our teacher sweethearts. Our 2023 male teacher sweetheart is Coach Dignan. Coach Dignan is in his ninth year at Garces. Currently, he's teaching PE, health, and the boys' basketball program head. Coach Dignan says, following when asked about his favorite parts of Garces, my favorite things are that we love our students, we have fun, and we compete. His favorite holiday is St. Patrick's Day. Our 2023 female teacher sweetheart is Senorita Salazar. Senorita Salazar has been teaching at Garces for 3 years. Currently, she is teaching Spanish 2, Spanish 4, and freshman theology. Senorita Salazar says the following about Garces. The best thing about working at Garces is my students and the fact that I can practice my faith. Her favorite holiday is Christmas. Congratulations, Coach Dignan and Senorita Salazar. Next, we have our freshman class prince and princess. The prince for the freshman class of 2027 is Bryce Hansen. Bryce is a three-sport athlete that plays football, basketball, and track. Additionally, he is a member of the Black Student Union. He presently has a GPA of 3.8. And Mrs. Reed's computer applications class is the most enjoyable. The community and the local support of Garces athletics programs are his favorite aspects of Garces. Bryce's favorite holiday is Thanksgiving because of all the time spent with family and the food. The princess for the freshman class of 2027 is Michelle Anton Giovanni. Michelle serves on the student council as freshman class representative. She is currently on the varsity cross country and varsity girls tennis teams, as well as playing club soccer. Later in the months, the school year, she plans on participating in Garces soccer and track and field. She is a member of Helping Hands, Interact Club, Go Gold, Pause, Program Cheer, Got the Dot, the Big Little Sis Club, Sports Marketing, and the Bass Club. At the moment, her weighted GPA is 4.2. Michelle's favorite class is computers, and she says the best part about Garces is the community and the school spirit. Her favorite holiday is Christmas because she gets to spend time with her family. Secondly, now we have our sophomore class, Prince and Princess. The prince for the sophomore class of 2026 is Gunter Kola III. Gunter is a one-sport athlete who participates in football. He's a member of the leadership organization, the Garces Shepherds. Gunter has been around football since he could walk and hopes to one day earn a scholarship to play collegiately and professionally. Gunter currently has a GPA 3.7. His all-time favorite class was Mr. Fanucchi's geometry class, and his current favorite class is chemistry with Mr. Parker. His favorite thing about Garces is the deep-rooted tradition and culture. And his favorite holiday is Easter, because it brings perfect weather, gets to celebrate the resurrection of Jesus, and he likes Easter egg hunt too. The princess for the sophomore class of 2026 is Olivia Tata Garcia. Olivia is a two-sport athlete participating in high school soccer and golf. She is part of the Garces Student Council as a sophomore class representative and is a member of the brass section of the Garces Band. Olivia is part of many clubs on campus, including Latina Leaders, Craft Club, Helping Hands, and the Go Gold Club. Olivia has a 3.6 GPA, and her favorite class is science with Mr. Parker. He's a fun guy, always makes me laugh, she says. Her favorite thing about Garces is how everyone knows everyone. It's like one big family. Olivia's favorite holiday is Christmas. She says, I love decorating the Christmas tree with my family and watching Christmas movies. Lastly, we have our junior class, Prince and Princess. The prince for the junior class of 2025 is Logan Slayton. Logan is a single sport athlete participating in football. He has been playing football since he was 11 and hopes to play in college. Additionally, Logan is a member of the Black Student Union. Logan is currently on the honor roll, and his favorite class is history with Mr. Gallen. His favorite thing about Garza is how compassionate the teachers are and how they push students to succeed. Logan's favorite holiday is Thanksgiving because he gets to spend time with the family. The 2023 princess for the junior class 2025 is Bella Chavez. Bella is a two-sport athlete participating in soccer and cross country. She is part of the Link crew and a member of the Helping Hands Club. Bella currently has a 3.8 GPA and her favorite classes are English and Spanish with some of her best friends, Caitlin and Natalia. Her favorite thing about Garza is the community and her friendship she's made. Bella's favorite holiday is Christmas because of the traditions, food, and the music. Ladies and gentlemen, please give our underclassmen, princes and princesses, one more huge round of applause. Next up, we have our senior homecoming court. In the first car, we're gonna hold off for 1 second. While we're waiting on the seniors, let's give one more big round of applause to our male teacher sweetheart, Coach Dignan. Our female teacher sweetheart, Senorita Salazar. Our freshman class prince and princess, Bryce Hansen and Michelle Anton Giovanni. A big round of applause for our sophomore prince and princess, Gunter Golem and Olivia Garcia. And another big round of applause for our junior prince and princess, Logan Slayton and Bella Chavez. A member of the Helping Hands and Engineering Clubs, as well as a PLTW scholar. Michael has a 3.7 GPA, and his favorite classes are Mrs. Cook's Architect class, Mrs. McKee's Anatomy class, and Mr. Detloff's Dual Enrollment English class. His favorite thing about Garza is the community that it's built around. His favorite holiday is Christmas because of the jolly atmosphere and the gift giving. The princess for the senior class of 2024 is Jocelyn Sala. Jocelyn is a co-ASB president and has participated in student council for all 4 years of her time here at Garza. She's on the varsity girls tennis team. Jocelyn is a three-time CF individual doubles champion and has won 2 Central Section Division I team titles along with her incredible Lady Rams. Jocelyn is current co-president of the Hispanic Latino Culture Club, a member of the Garza Shepherds, and has participated in the Garza Drama Club for the past 3 years. Jocelyn currently has a 4.01 weighted GPA, and her favorite class is ASB with Mrs. Thompson in English Expository Composition, with Mr. Detloff. Her favorite thing about Garza is the immense amount of spirit for the students and administrators, as well as the complete family feeling Garza holds. Jocelyn's favorite holiday is Christmas because of all the great songs she loves to listen to and the traditions she has with family and friends during the holiday season. In the second car, we have homecoming court members Caden Towery and Gemma Eddy. The prince of the senior class of 2024 is Caden Towery. Caden is a varsity water polo player. Caden is also a member of the ASB and participates in clubs including Helping Hands and Interact Club. Caden is an honor roll student, and his two favorite classes are ASB with Mrs. Thompson because of how fun of a person she is, and anatomy with Ms. McKee because of her patience. His favorite thing about Garza is the pride, the school spirit Garza High School brings. Caden's favorite holiday is Christmas because of the cooler weather and loves to visit places like Mammoth to go snowboarding. The princess for the senior class 2024 is Gemma Eddy. Gemma is co-president of Sports Marketing Club and her ASB Athletics Commissioner. She's a two-sport varsity athlete in tennis for 3 years and soccer for 4 seasons. Gemma has won 2 Division I team championships in tennis and hopes to gain another this fall. She's a member of the Interact Club, Helping Hands, and Garza Shepherds. Gemma currently has a 4.0 cumulative GPA and is a part of CSF. Her favorite class here at Garza is ASB with Mrs. Thompson because of the last every morning second period in theology with Mr. Panic because we get to see James and Gianna. Her favorite thing about Garza is the family aspect, being able to spend her 4 years here with her best friends. Gemma's favorite holiday is Christmas because of her family traditions, trips to Mammoth, and the Italian dinners her family makes on nights before the day of Christmas. In the third car, we have senior homecoming court members Isaiah Crisco and Stella Holland. The prince for the senior class 2024 is Isaiah Crisco. Isaiah is a three-sport athlete participating in water polo, wrestling, and lacrosse. He is co-ASB president in addition to president of 2 school clubs such as robotics and chess. He is also a member of the clubs such as Interact Club, Helping Hands, a mock trial, and the Engineering Club. Isaiah has deep passion for engineering, which is why PLTW is his favorite class. He plans to follow engineering into college by studying aerospace engineering. Isaiah's favorite thing about Garza is the loving community from staff and students. Isaiah's favorite holiday is Thanksgiving because he gets to see his entire family. The princess for the senior class 2024 is Stella Holland. Stella has swam and played water polo for all 4 years at Garza. She is a member of the National Honor Society, Helping Hands, and Art Club. Stella is ASB Rally Commissioner, CSF President, and a member of the Ford Dream Builders. She's a proud owner of her small business, Stella's Artwork, and hopes to pursue a career in design. Stella currently has a 4.82 weighted GPA, and her favorite classes are ASB with Mrs. Thompson, since she gets to make posters in English with Mr. Detloff. Stella's favorite thing about Garza is the uniform and the fact that it gave her her best friends. Her favorite holiday is Christmas because she gets to dress as Santa at her family events. And last but not least, we have senior homecoming court members Kagan McCarthy and Jade Jameson. The prince of the senior class 2024 is Kagan McCarthy. Kagan is a two-sport athlete participating in football and track and field. He is one of the senior class representatives and member of the Helping Hands Club, as well as the Garza Shepherds. Kagan currently has a cumulative GPA of 4.35, and his favorite class is ASB with Mrs. Thompson. His favorite thing about Garza is the amazing friends he has met since transferring here. Kagan's favorite holiday is Christmas, because the winter is the best, and the presents are cool, and he can spend time with his family. And the princess for the senior class 2024 is Jade Jameson. Jade is a two-sport athlete playing tennis and softball. She is a senior class president. She's also a member of the Helping Hands Club, Link Crew, and her Garza Shepherds. Jade currently has a 4.3 weighted GPA, and her favorite class is ASB with Mrs. Thompson. Her favorite thing about Garza is how easy it is to be involved. Jade's favorite holiday is Thanksgiving because it's the perfect weather and she gets to spend it with her whole family. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it the entire homecoming court one more big, big round of applause. Please join us at halftime for homecoming festivities, which include a performance from our cheerleaders, class skits, and the crowning of our homecoming king and queen.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's been nearly a month, but we are happy to say welcome back to Sam Tobias Field here on a beautiful October evening for our 2023 homecoming here at Garces Memorial High School here on GMSN on the Garces Athletics YouTube channel. I am Trevor Horn, the Sports Information Director and Director of Communications here at Garces Memorial, and I'm joined by my partner in crime, the one, the only, the legendary, do not allow him to call himself old.
Oh, yes, I am.
John L. Finucchi.
Thank you, Trevor.
Coach, so here we are. We have a 2-4 Rams team that's coming off of a 41-13 loss to Liberty last week, taking on an undefeated Frontier team here on homecoming. And there are a lot of things that you get excited about in a game like this is what you really kind of get excited about, because what you have is you have a team that is fighting for a playoff spot in the Rams and a team that's trying to keep that undefeated season going, knowing that tonight is their league opener because last week they played their cross rival in Ridgeview on the road. So you have a very dynamic situation going on here where the Rams have played the third toughest schedule in the Central Section, whereas Frontier, they've played one of the weakest schedules, if you will, in the top 25 in the Central Section. So it's a very unique situation, very high-powered offense, two great quarterbacks, and Gunter Goller, the sophomore for Garces, and the senior in Malachi Statler for Frontier. When you look at something like this, Coach, you've been on both ends. You've been 6-0, you've been 2-4. You've had them both on homecoming. In your mindset, where should Coach Gola and these Rams be on a night like this?
Well, you know, I think in a night like this, I think that it's so easy to go in that locker room and say, guys, at the end of tonight, our goal is to be 1-0. Our goal is to win this game against a very established, developed team. And if we can do that, then we've shown that we've grown leaps and bounds since the start of the season.
And before we get started on the football game, and I hope you guys enjoyed the opening procession of our homecoming court. You got to see our freshman prince and princess. That is Bryce Hansen, who you'll see on the field quite a bit at wide receiver and at DB for the varsity team tonight. And then Michelle Anton Giovanni, who is no slouch in herself. She's on varsity cross country and girls tennis. Our sophomore prince and princess is Gunter Gola, our starting quarterback, and Olivia Garcia, who is going to be a two-year varsity starter, is starting on varsity last year in girls soccer. Our junior prince and princess are Logan Slayton and Bella Chavez. Logan, you'll see a bunch tonight at running back and at middle linebacker. Those are our underclassmen, princes and princesses. We even have teacher sweethearts, the one, the only, Coach Dignan, and Senorita Salazar, two fantastic human beings on our campus. And our senior princesses this year, Stella Holland, Jay Jameson, Gemma Eddy, Jocelyn Sala, all varsity standouts in their own right here in the fall, with Stella on water polo, Jade on girls tennis, Gemma on girls tennis, along with Jossie on girls tennis. And our senior princesses are all also great student athletes. And when I say student athletes, I'm talking about students first. And Isaiah Crisco, water polo. Kagan McCarthy, you'll see Big Red tonight here, number 8. Caden Towery, water polo. And Michael Benign, also water polo. Congratulations to all of them. At halftime, you guys will be able to see us crown our prince and princesses tonight. We are just about 3 minutes away. 3 minutes away.
You know, Trevor, there's nothing like homecoming. Oh, gosh, what a beautiful young man.
Days like this, I miss my son and my daughter, my son and my wife, but I enjoy this week. It's so fun and exciting as the Rams have come on the field. Captains going up to 13, 71, 17, and 9. So those are your captains for Frontier. Your captains, Gunter Gola, Jackson Fleming, the sophomore. Who else is out there? Logan Slayton, number 27, and number 55, Gino Lefevre. The captains tonight for Frontier, number 13, Malachi Statler, we'll call his name out a lot. The freshman, number 71, Karsten Campbell. Coach, you know him quite well. Number 13, Malachi Statler. Number 71. I'm listening to Guy for the other two. Campbell. And we'll call out those other two in just a second. We got about 2 minutes left here before kickoff. We're going to wait to see who is going to receive this game to start off. First, we'd like to be able to thank our title sponsor, SCOE, Southern California Orthopedic Institution. Thank you for your continued support as our title sponsor this year. Also, thanks to Sean McNally, Clarue Tires, and Gian Quinto Ortho Arts. Thank you all so much for your continued service along with Mission Bank. We couldn't do this without you.
You know, Trevor, I know the future is right now. But what's neat to see is that every one of our captains out there will be playing for the Rams next year.
Yep. Did you see the call, Coach? I'm sorry, I was looking down for just a half a second.
You know what? I didn't see it, darn it.
All right, so we're going to take a quick break for opening prayer and playing on the national anthem. We will be right back, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Garces Memorial Sportsnet here on the Garces Athletic YouTube channel. And my eyes are all messed up right now, Coach. I see Coach Dignan wearing a tie and a nice button-down shirt right now. It must be a special occasion for Coach Dignan.
Don't get used to it.
I don't. Because if he's not wearing shorts and a T-shirt, I don't really know what to do here. So the Rams have deferred the opening toss. And Frontier will start the game off here on offense. That means that the Rams will, as you always like, be able to get the ball to start the second half. So really, the key right now is to slow down this Frontier offense. It hasn't been slowed down much this year. They've got wins over Bullard, over Ridgeview, over North High, over Independence, over Hanford, which is a very good win for them. So this is a Frontier team coming off a big win over Ridgeview last week coming in. This is their league opener. The Rams are 2-4 and 0-1 in league play after that loss on the road last Thursday to Liberty. But it's homecoming, and that's everything else gets put to bed on a night like this as Sammy Gonzalez gets ready to kick it off here at Sam Tobias Field. And we are ready to go. And it's a pooch kick right to about the 35. Frontier will field it right at the 30. Cuts around to the 35. Brought down by Ricky Johnson right around the 40-yard line. It is number 32, Dante Calles. And that's where Frontier will start this first drive of this game. Right at the 40-yard line for Frontier. Good idea for the Rams to pooch it there where they have two lethal returners for Frontier. Nice little 15, 10, 12-yard return for Casillas. And Frontier will have just 60 yards in front of them here on this opening drive. Quarterback Malachi Statler, 103 for 136 passing, 1,686 yards, 23 touchdowns, just 5 interceptions this season. He had 6 touchdowns against North High earlier this year. Motion, 2 backs. Malcolm Watkins in motion, and that's where he'll catch the ball. Get about a yard on that. Coach, you got to turn your ringer off on broadcast. All right, so that's a 1 yard gain there for Frontier, so that'll make it 2nd and 9 from the 41. 2nd and 9. Empty formation for Statler now. He drops back. He's got pressure on the backside.
Great job.
And that ball's out. And the Rams recover it. Johnny Lester, Johnny on the spot. Luke Napier starting tonight for the first time this season. Picks it up, and the Rams recover it. And they'll get the ball at the 30-yard line.
Boy, you couldn't ask for a better start, Trevor. Because
no, sir.
Because basically the way that works out is we start both halves with the ball.
You darn right. Great play by the defense. Great pressure on the backside by Lester. And the Rams will start at the Frontier 31. Great field position to start it off here for Garces. Austin Hernandez in the backfield with Gola. Gola, high snap. He's just going to have to fall on it. So that's an unfortunate situation there for the Rams.
In a situation like that, Gunter did exactly the right thing. Don't try to be a hero there. Live to fight another day.
So 7 yard loss, make it 2nd and 17. Sometimes you're a little too amped up there, Edgar Cueva, but that's okay.
You
know
what?
We'll get it figured out.
Exactly.
It's been a busy week on campus. A lot of emotions going into this one. Gola looks, fires, finds Hernandez on the outside. He gets past the 35, keeps going. Back to about the original line of scrimmage, so about an 8 yard gain there.
And that's exactly what you want to do in a situation like that, is don't try to get it all at once. Take it, because you're probably in 4 down territory here.
Yep, so an 8 yard completion there for Gola to Hernandez. Gets it 3rd and 9. So a ball right at the 30-yard line. 3rd and long for the Rams. 10:09 left here in the first quarter. Scoreless after Frontier's quarterback Malachi Statler fumbled the ball after being sacked by Johnny Lester. Luke Napier picked it up. Rams recover. Bad snap pushed them back. And now we have a timeout, Frontier. So we'll have a quick timeout again. We'd like to thank our title sponsor, SCOE, Southern California Orthopedic Institution, for their continued support of Garces Athletics, Garces Memorial High School, and here on GMSN. Also, Sean McNally, thank you, brother. Clearu Tires, Mission Bank, Gian Quinto, Ortho Arts, thank you all so much for your continued support of the Garces Memorial Sports Net. Coach, 3rd and 9 here. They take timeout. Your Gola, your idea here is probably to read the middle linebacker, see where he is, and probably don't try to throw it deep. Just try to find something in space and see what you can do, because you're obviously probably in 4 down territory.
Absolutely. So really you're looking at getting 8 yards or 9 yards in 2 plays.
Yep.
And that makes the 3rd so critical, because you'd like to have the 4th down somewhere between maybe 4 and 5 yards.
All right, here we go. 3rd and 9 from the 30 after the Frontier timeout. Trips to the left for the Rams. Hernandez in the backfield. Frontier is stacking the box, but still going man-to-man here on the left side. It's actually quads of left if you count Jack Froelich in that Auburn position because he is a wide receiver in an Auburn back position. Completely empty on the top half of your screen, ladies and gentlemen. And that looks like a delay of game. Wait for the call from the white hat, but that looked like it was a delay of game, or was it a timeout?
I think maybe it was a timeout because it looked like Frontier may have looked a little confused as to where to line up.
It asked it's a Garces timeout. Okay. I think that what they were trying to do was probably try to get him off sides or just kind of feel out to see what they were doing there. So
correct.
A little bit of gamesmanship going on from Coach Bandy over there at Frontier and our own Coach Gola here at Garces. So two longtime coaches here in town. Bandy, obviously a longtime assistant under Dennis Manning at West High and Ridgeview. And they took over the Frontier program 5 years ago.
Five or six years ago.
Yep, exactly. So two head coaches looking for, you know, a little head spin. Frontier ranked number 7 in the Central Section right now. Obviously, you know, in the D1 conversation, both teams are D2 base. And the Rams are basically sitting in that number 2, number 3 seed in Division 2. But however this game kind of plays out is really going to play into that. So here we go, 3rd and 9 from the 30. Hands it off to Hernandez. Hernandez takes it about 5 yards up to about the 24-yard line. So just like we talked about, Coach, it's a 4-down territory.
Well, now
so
we have a flag.
Yep. So that ball goes all the way down to the 24. So that was a 6-yard gain for Hernandez.
Looks like it's against Frontier, so we'll have a first down.
And that looks like a personal foul against Frontier. So that's going to add another 15 yards to that 6-yard carry. So that's going to bring the Rams all the way down to the 12-yard line, ladies and gentlemen. So that's a personal foul against Frontier. We saw a lot of chippiness in the JV game. We hope that doesn't transpire here into the varsity game. And that's on both sides of the ball. So hopefully we have a clean game. That's the one and only Guy Cook on the PA announcer this evening here at Sam Tobias Field. So here we go. Again, we got quads to the left. Hernandez in the backfield with Gola. How much does that right side of the field for Gola, maybe on a little play action here, work? We'll see. And there's an offsides. Oof. And that number 88, he pushed the line pretty hard. That's Brian Hawley. And that's another 5 yards that'll go for the Rams. So that's an offsides on the Titans. And that'll move it down to the 7-yard line. So that'll make a 1st and 5 from the 7. So the Rams are knocking on the door to score here first tonight in this big River League matchup between these two teams. Hernandez gets the ball, chops around the first line of scrimmage, probably gets down about the 4-3-yard line. Let's see. Yep, down to the 3-yard line, so 4 yards there for Hernandez.
And if I'm not mistaken, we can still get a first down without scoring.
Yeah, we've got about a 0.5 yard or so between, so 2nd and about 1 from the 3. Gola, Froelich goes in motion. Gola keeps the ball, falls in.
Touchdown.
Touchdown, Garces. Guter Gola from the 3-yard line. And the Rams take an early 6-0 lead over the Titans. Great way to get the turnover and, you know, that bad first snap. They're able to drive the ball, take the penalties as they come, and score that touchdown.
And a great call down on the goal line. The option, such a great call down on the goal line because it really allows Gunter to make a couple of important calls.
By Gunter Gola, Rams take the whatever lead, 7-0 lead, and make sure you get the time on the clock. 8:23 left in the first.
So with 8:23 left here in the first quarter, Garces with a big 7-0 lead over the Titans. So the defense did their job to start, and the offense came back and said, you know what? We got this too, ladies and gentlemen. So the Rams quickly with a 7-0 lead here, 8:23 left in the first quarter.
And a very positive thing that cannot be overlooked is the fact that after a 7-yard loss, they were still able to hold things together, get the first down, and eventually get in the end zone.
Couldn't agree with you more, Coach. A nice little swing pass to Hernandez for 8 yards, and then Hernandez had that 6-yard run, and then you tack on the 15-yard penalty, then the offsides. Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize about the little technical difficulties up here on the beautiful deck here at Sam Tobias Field. But we are back, and the Titans, they are threatening here. First and 10 at the Rams 10-yard line. Statler drops back, looks deep, incomplete. So with 4:59 here left in the first quarter, what you missed was Frontier taking the opening drive, and they started at the 35-yard line. Statler to Watkins for a 14-yard pass right to the 50, and then a short run of 6 yards, and then Statler was able to take it 14 yards down to the 32. Through an incompletion, then he completed a 22-yard pass to number 14, Austin Tapia, and we are all caught up. The Rams are leading 7-0 over the Titans. Here we have 2nd and 10 at the Rams 10, 4:59 left here in the first quarter. And the undefeated Titans still scoreless here in the first quarter, trailing the Rams 7-0. Statler drops back, rolls out, looks, pressured, running, looking. Slayton throws it up into the air, and wow, a pick-me 50-50 ball picked up by Song Ginyu, and a 10-yard touchdown for the Titans, and quickly they respond, and it looks like the Titans have a player down after that touchdown with 4:47 left. Incredible pass play there, Coach.
You know, what can you do? I mean, he gets out of trouble, he scrambles, he throws the ball up. I won't say for grabs, but a great play by that wide receiver to make that catch.
So that's just a repost.
So Frontier able to respond there after a 65-yard drive. No penalties on that drive. Clean. PAT pending here. And that is good. So that will tie it up here. 7-7. 4:49 left. 4:47, excuse me, left here in the first quarter. And both offenses clicking
I think
in the last two
I think
drives.
The young man that just made the extra point, if I'm reading that right, I think it's Ryder Crane Finch. Is that correct? Did I read that correct?
Yeah,
it was number 18.
Yeah. You are correct, sir. I won't correct you. You're the legendary. Hey, we got some dignitaries here tonight. Ron Staff from B Varsity is here, along with photographer Rodney Thornburg. See, Kyle Kerr from Hometown Sports is here. Mickey Van Horn from KGET. Sadly, Channel 23 KERO no longer has a sports department, so they are not here this season at all. It's unfortunate, but we hope to see them realizing that high school sports and athletics in general in Kern County matter very much. Very, very much, Coach.
You know, there's a lot of ways to build and develop character, and high school athletics is certainly one of them, and football's one of the great things about that.
So that ball will be received by Austin Hernandez right at the 1 yard line. He's going to take it to the 25, and there's a burst out to the 27, almost to the 30 yard line.
Good coverage by the Frontier team, but also a good return. So the Rams start off in fairly good field position at the, I think it's around the 30 yard line.
When it's that burst of speed by Austin Hernandez,
absolutely.
That is just, it's so enjoyable to watch, because when it happens in a blink and he's gone.
And if he's not gone going one way, he'll reverse his field and go the other way.
We saw that last week against Liberty on that 59 yard scamper.
Absolutely.
Yep, so here we go. Hernandez in the backfield with Gola. Trips to the right. Hernandez gets the ball up the middle. He gets right past that first line of scrimmage, about 7 yards up to the 37-yard line. So another great run there by Hernandez, just churning up yards, 17 yards on three carries.
And I know we've said it before, but second and three opens up the entire playbook. You can run, you can pass, you can play action. There's a whole lot of things you can do with it.
Actually got 8 yards there, Coach. We're up to the 38-yard line, so second and two. Great way to stop. Look at this gentleman behind us wearing that great shirt. What is that? Mike, the Gales. Second and two. We're all tied up here with 3:59 left here in the first quarter. Garces with the ball. Gola quickly hands off. Is that Ricky Johnson? It is. Man, he is just going. Gets the first down past the 45 up to the 46. And he's just a man on a mission. One of the strongest sophomores I've ever seen run the ball at the high school
level.
Number
4, Ricky Johnson with the carry over the right side, left side.
up to the 46-yard line. So a 6-yard carry there.
You know, the great thing about Ricky, it's true of a lot of these players, but he went from good to great this year simply by his dedication in the offseason.
Oh, yeah, we talked about it, I think, on every broadcast.
Absolutely.
30 pounds of pure muscle that he's put on. He hasn't lost an ounce of that speed. So here's Johnson again. Bust up. Ooh, nice little burst there after getting stopped at the line of scrimmage. Gets up to the 49-yard line. So, you know, what looked like it was no gain.
Again.
Gets 3 yards out of it.
Got something out of what could have been nothing.
Back in our day, you know what we called that, Coach? 3 yards in a cloud of dust.
Yes, absolutely. And here's the great thing.
There's no dust on this field tonight.
They just brought Ricky out, and they just brought a junior running back in
Logan Slayton.
So,
I mean, and you still have R.J. Green that can spell in that fourth spot at the wide receiver.
Absolutely.
And all four of them are fantastic linebackers, Austin being a DB as well. So Slayton this time gets the ball right at the 50. He busts up the line of scrimmage, still trying to find a little room, maybe gets about 2 yards there to the opposite 49. So I'll make it third and five.
That'll bring up third down.
Hi, Mary Louise Hazel.
Hi.
How are you?
You were sitting in the center section on the Garson.
That was a very nice way that he said your name there, Mary D'Amato.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't want to think about that. Third and four, the Rams on the frontier, 49-yard line, bunch formation for the Rams, and that's going to be an offsides on the Titans, and that's going to gift the Rams a first down. Oh, no, they're calling a false start on Garces. So that's going to make it third and 10. I'm sure that there'll be a few people listening that'll think I'm crazy. That's okay. One of them that's listening that's not going to think I'm crazy is the one, the only Travis Pluggy, the St. Thomas University quarterback. Trav, hope you're doing well. Hope the weather hasn't gotten too cold for you. I'm sure you're going to go Twins right now. Big excitement in St. Paul, Minneapolis with the Minnesota Twins winning that opening round wild card series as Gunter drops back, fires. He's got Jack Froelich there, but great defense there by Ginyu to knock that pass up. It'll fall incomplete, make it fourth down, and that will force the Rams to punt from their own 46-yard line. So the first time we've seen either two teams punt with 1:43 left here in the second quarter. That thing looked like a bat for a second, man.
Absolutely.
We got moths the size of bats up here.
You know the great thing about our punt team? A, you don't want to punt a whole lot. But we have a guy back there punting who's a threat every time he has his hands on the ball.
And that is Mr. Cage Williams. So he gets that punt off, and that's a nice little punt that'll land around the 20, and that's going to go all the way back. And it looks like Watkins is going to try to return that. He's dancing around the 10. He gets away, and he's got a blocker in front of him. He's up to the 30, to the 35, still breaks away. And, ladies and gentlemen, he's gone. That's a 95-yard punt return for Malcolm Watkins. And quickly, no flags on the field to be seen. So a long punt return for Malcolm Watkins, which looked like he was going to get dragged down around the 10-yard line, gets a blocker and Ginyu in front of him, and he just does the work himself. So 90-yard punt return there for Malcolm Watkins. 90-yard punt return, and Frontier quickly takes a lead here for the first time.
Because, you know, a really nice punt. And I personally thought that ball was going to be downed at the 10 or inside the 10.
Or he was just going to let it.
Yes, that's what
but
I mean.
That's
I mean.
A very confident young man in
Absolutely.
Malcolm Watkins, just a sophomore for the Titans. So with 1:19 left here in the first quarter, you see the athleticism of the Titans coming to play here as they take the lead for the first time. PAT pending here, and that is Mr. Ryder Crane Finch, a junior. That ball is up, and it is good. So the Titans take a 14-7 lead over the Rams. And that is probably a great time to once again thank our title sponsor, SCOWE, Southern California Orthopedic Institution, our title sponsor this year here on GMSN. I am Trevor Horn, along with the one, the only, the legendary John Finucchi. We'd also like to thank our other sponsors, Mission Bank, Kaleru Tires. George, we know you're listening if you're not here in the stands. Sean McNally, he's always listening. And Gianquinto Ortho Arts, thank you so much for your continued support of GMSN and Garces Memorial Athletics. We appreciate it so much. We couldn't do this without you. If you're interested in advertising with this broadcast, please let us know. Email me at thorn@garces.org. We'll get your name out there. If you want to support us, it'd be fantastic.
Trevor, I don't think this is overstated. Someone might say it is. With a minute 19 left in the first quarter, I think that our next series on offense is a big, big series for us.
I couldn't agree more.
We have to reestablish the control that we established the first time we had the ball.
All right, so here we go. Hernandez will once again take this punt right around the 5-yard line. He's looking for a block. He doesn't get it. He's wrapped up right around the 25-yard line, maybe up to the 26. And that's where the Rams will start this drive, trailing for the first time this evening, Coach.
Number 5, Austin Hernandez on the return stop by number 6, Tyler Ayala.
You know, we simply have to go in that huddle and say, guys, let's do what we did on the first series. Let's move the ball. Let's let them make mistakes. Let's stay penalty free. If they're going to make mistakes, let's let them. But let's just make sure that we're taking care of our own business.
So here we go. The Rams, first and 10 at their own 26-yard line. Logan Slayton in the backfield with Gola. Trips to the top half of your screen. And Slayton will get the ball, dances around right around midfield and quickly wrapped up there. Nice sportsmanship there.
Attention Garson students.
By number 22, James Moon there after picking off Slayton.
Boards in place and head to the north end of the field at this time.
Ball goes up to the 28, so that'll make it second and 8 after a 2-yard gain for Logan Slayton.
You know, it's a 2-yard gain that could have very easily been a 3-yard loss. And that's the thing about Logan Slayton. He's always going to fall forward.
Ricky Johnson now in the backfield with Gola. Gola takes the ball. He looks. He pitches out to Johnson. Johnson looks for a seam and gets pushed out of bounds very quickly.
Ricky Johnson takes the Gola pitch. Forced out of bounds. Third down.
Okay, that ball is up to the 28-yard line, so no gain there for Johnson. Make it 3rd and 8. And so that will be the end of the first quarter. Frontier 14, Garces 7. Coach, we'll take a quick break, and we'll be right back. All right, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are here. Start of the second quarter. Frontier leading your Garces Rams 14-7. The Rams 3rd and 8 from their own 28-yard line. Obvious passing play here. We do have a whistle. Looks like that might have been James Moon having to come off the field, probably for a pad issue. He is getting replaced by Dante Clejas. So we're back at it here. Waiting for that first play here in the second quarter. Gola with Johnson in the backfield with him. Gola drops back. He's got a wide receiver wide open, and that's Nate Wallace, but Gola wrapped up behind the line of scrimmage. A trio of Titans there, first led by Roy Vaughn, a former Ram there with the sack on Gola. and that will force another punt by the Rams offense.
Brings up a Ram fourth down.
Four-yard loss there, makes it fourth and 12, and we'll see Cage Williams out to punt again. Unfortunate situation there because Nate Wallace seemed to get a seam right here along this line, and if Gola was able to get him, he was probably going to get him in stride and probably going to be a nice completion there. Williams with a nice punt, and this one's going to go out of bounds. And that's Mike Smith reminding everybody he can still catch. Hopefully we'll get him back for Bakersfield Christian next week. That game will be on the road on Saturday at 7:30. We will not be live streaming that. We do not do road games because I can't secure Wi-Fi, so that's why we stick to games here at Sam Tobias Field. That would be a fun contest in our cross-rival fellow brothers and sisters in Christ over Bakersfield Christian next Saturday. And then the following October 20th will be Friday night here back at Sam Tobias Field for the last home game of the regular season on senior night against
Centennial.
Against Centennial, and then we'll finish up the regular season on Thursday, October 26th at Stockdale. So the Titans will start off their third possession here at their own 47-yard line. Statler drops back. Great coverage by the Rams, but great protection there by the O-line, but that falls incomplete short in the middle of the field, and that will go incomplete.
And like you said, great coverage by the Rams. He really didn't have anywhere to throw the ball. To his credit, he got the ball away, and so now he comes back to second and 10, and the defensive backfield has to continue to play like that.
So the Titans still on their own 47-yard line. There's 11:01 left here in the second quarter. Frontier with a 14-7 lead here on GMSN on the Garcia Athletic YouTube channel. Under center, very rarely do we see Malachi Statler under center, but he drops back and he's getting pressured there by RJ Green and just has to throw it away. So very, he did have a receiver there in coverage, and that ball does go out of bounds. But that was a great pressure there by RJ Green to force the second straight incompletion by Statler.
And you can see that what Coach Gold is doing. The two guys that were putting the pressure on him were two linebackers. So obviously R.J. Green and Logan Slayton. So obviously Coach Gold has decided that they're going to dial up pressure as much as they can to put him in a situation where he can't just sit back and find open receivers.
Already three incompletions, four incompletions tonight. He's 4 of 8 tonight. Very rarely do you see 4 of 8, 50% from Malachi Statler, somebody who's completed 76% of his passes this year. 103 for 136, 1,686 yards passing this season. Now has 24 touchdown passes, just 5 interceptions. Statler drops back, pressure this time again by Logan Slayton. He overthrows his receiver, Kobe Watson, by about 5 yards as Cage Williams was in coverage, and that's a quick three and out there. Great job by the Rams defense.
Again, great coverage on all three downs. Nowhere to throw the football on any of the three.
So Titans will punt for the first time this evening from their own 47. Somehow that ball got back to the 46. Well, okay. It's good for us. Cage Williams back to receive, standing at right at the 16-yard line. That is Ryder Crane Finch. Gets this ball off a high punt. It's going to land right about the 25, and they're just going to peter that one out. Cage isn't going to try to do anything with it, and that ball will land right at the 14-yard line. And that's where the Rams will start. So great job by the defense for the Rams. Slows down the Frontier offense, which is kind of incredible if you think about it. Statler's only one of his last five, and the one being that scramble kind of 50-50 ball for the touchdown. So you take that away and you take that incredible punt return away, and you know, it's just, but again, it's one of those things. It's, you got to make the big plays
Absolutely.
Happen, and you sometimes you got to make ugly plays look good. So the Rams at their own 14-yard line to start this one. Austin Hernandez in the backfield one more time with Gola, and Hernandez will take it, dances around, gets past the 15 up to the 17-yard line, so a 3-yard carry there by Austin Hernandez. And really, I mean, if you think about it, if the Rams are able to just kind of get 3 yards here, 5 yards there, 8 yards here, that keeps the Frontier explosive offense off the field.
Off the field, that's
and
right.
I don't see any problem with that. I mean, if this is a 21-14 game, I don't think anybody's complaining.
Absolutely not.
The only thing that matters is that that upside down M. Come on, that was funny. Second and 7 from the 17, upside down M. It's a W.
Coach. I understand.
Gola drops back. He's looking. He's got Bryce Hansen. Hansen with a great catch at the 35, dances around, finally knocked out of bounds at the 38-yard line. Great catch there by the freshman. My goodness. And great look there by Gola.
And just a very athletic play all the way around, from the throw from Gunter to the great catch made by Bryce.
22-yard gain there. Gola now 2 for 3 for 30 yards. And the Rams have a first down at the 39-yard line. Great catch, kind of leaping ability. And if you've ever seen Bryce Hansen play basketball, you wouldn't be surprised because his jump shot, he gets about a foot, foot and a half off the ground after every jump shot. So there's Hernandez one more time, and he loses a yard there on that one.
Hernandez met immediately by number 8.
So he's got 20 yards on 5 carries now, second and 11 from the 38-yard line for the Rams. 9:14 left here in the second quarter here on GMSN and the Garza Athletics YouTube channel. Trevor Horn along with John Finucci. In the background, you can start to see all the skits for the halftime festivities coming. And that's going to be a run for Hernandez, even though it was a pass play. And he's going to get maybe back to the original line of scrimmage. There's a Frontier player kind of coming out of nowhere as that ball get up to the 40-yard line. 2 yard gain there for Hernandez.
Third and 8, third and 9, somewhere around there.
So we're going to give Hernandez a run on that because it was a backwards pass. That's
absolutely, absolutely. Yep. Probably thrown 2 yards backward, so it wasn't even near exactly down the line. The idea is to get him into open space.
Yeah. And, I have a funny situation about that in just a second, okay. Coach. You'll laugh about this one. So right at the 40-yard line, third and 9 for the Rams. Gola looks. He's got pressure. He's rolling out. He's looking for Jack Froelich. Finds Froelich right at, they're calling it incomplete, even though it looked like he got his hands underneath, but the line judge is saying that ball is incomplete.
Well, you know, I know I've seen it through green eyes, but that looked like a catch to me.
It did. It did. So that'll force another punt here for the Rams. So against the Menachie game, Gunter broke the school record with 6 touchdown passes that night, 407 yards passing, right? So one of the touchdowns was the same kind of swing pass to Ricky Johnson, who ran it in for a touchdown. And it would have given him 7 touchdowns that night. But the thing is that it's a backwards pass. It's a run.
Absolutely.
So that's my funny story. So Cage Williams back to punt one more time. The Titans have 2 players back there to receive. So that means less area to protect him, and that's going to roll, geez, all the way down to maybe the 20-yard line. Great punt there by Cage Williams.
Williams' punt rolls out of bounds.
So Frontier will get the ball back with exactly 8 minutes left here in the first half.
Frontier will take over first and 10.
Big defensive series here for Garces, trailing by 7 into the second quarter. It's important that we stop them here, get the ball back.
All right, so the Titans will start this drive on their own 18-yard line. If you guys have been listening this season, no, I have not gotten new prescription for my eyes, so I'll do my best. So, again, Statler looks like he's under center on this one. Motion, trips to the bottom half of your screen, and that's a handoff. And that one will get stopped right around the 23-yard line, maybe up to the 24. About a 6-yard gain there to the 24-yard line, make it 2nd and 4.
I think they're going to continue having a difficult time running the ball against us. But that's a nice gain for them because 2nd and 4 is certainly manageable, and our defense has to step up and be ready to stop the run and the pass in a situation like this.
Empty backfield for Statler. Looks, quickly fires out. finds number 14, Austin Tapia, for the first down.
Statler's pass complete to number 14, Austin Tapia. Drug down by number 21.
So that ball goes up to the 33-yard line, a 9-yard reception there.
Again, you know, a nice tackle by Bryce, because when you're all they're trying to do is get that receiver the ball in open space, and it just becomes one-on-one from there.
First and 10 for the Titans. They're on 33-yard line, leading the Rams 14-7, 6:53 left here in the second quarter. Big series here for the Rams defense. Don't want to go down two touchdowns here in the first half. Ooh, great pressure there by Statler, but he holds in there, fires, finds Taylen Ramirez for the catch across the middle. I mean, he got tattooed in the backfield.
A nice throw, but you know, a nice throw and catch, but a nice tackle by Cage to keep it from more damage not having been done.
Now 71 yards passing for Statler here in the first half, as the Titans are at their own 46. Again, a nice run up the middle. Oh, and that is gone, ladies and gentlemen. 54 yards to the house. Number 32, Dante Casillas, if I am correct there. And that is
22.
Number 32.
I'm sorry.
Dante
Casillas. 54 yards on that touchdown run. And just like I said, big series for the defense, and they give up that long run right up the middle, and he's able to use his speed to go all the way down for the touchdown. And quickly, it's a 20-7 lead for the Titans. .611 left here in the second, and the Rams offense has to get something going here.
Exactly. You know, not a situation that you want to be in, but a situation that can be corrected by one strong offensive series.
Left-footed booter there is Ryder Crane Finch, and that will give the Titans a 21-7 lead here with 6:11 left.
Mrs. Rossi will be in there.
All right, 6:11 left here, Coach. The Rams got to get something going here. And I know that you could tell that they've been trying to, you know, pull that frontier defense in and hoping they can find something long, but you got to be able to find something in the pass game to extend these drives and get back in the end zone. That first drive, they did their job. They took the penalties that were given to them, and they took the good field position, and they ran it in for that opening drive. But they haven't been able to do anything since. So something's got to give here, because you got to score points against a team like Frontier, because they're not going to stop scoring.
Correct. And, you know, and they've scored on two big plays.
Yeah.
A great punt return, and then, well, I say two big plays. They had two good runs on that last series.
So here's the kick. It is deep, and that is going to be grabbed by Hernandez right around the 7-yard line. He comes down to his left, cuts back to his right like he likes to, and finally is brought down right around the 24-yard line. So that's where the Rams will start this drive, needing to put some points on the board here. Because here's the thing, if they're able to turn this clock down to about a minute or two, and you get it within third quarter, Rams get the ball back.
Absolutely.
Very crucial to score here.
Okay, 24.
All right, ball's at the 24-yard line. And Golo will have Logan Slayton with him in the backfield. So here we go. Golo drops back, fires. And that is almost picked off there by James Moon. He was looking for Jack Froelich down the seam. That's worked out quite a few times this year, but not this time. Golo now 2 for 5 for 30 yards passing.
I think that pass kind of got away from him. I don't think he got the height on it that he wanted. I don't know what the problem was, but that's normally a pass that Gunter completes.
Still a warm evening here in October. High was around 92 today. Quick pitch out to Slayton, and he just has to fall on it after he bobbles that handoff, and that's all the way back to the 19, so a four-yard loss there. Five-yard loss, excuse me. So that'd be third and 15. And again, situations like that can't happen when you're down two scores against a potent offense like Frontier. So the Rams, with 5:30 and counting left here in the first half, have third and forever in front of them at their own 19-yard line. You not only want to get this play off because you want to get out of your own back half of the red zone. You want to not give Frontier the ball back in midfield. You want to extend this drive. So Gola drops, looks, fires. He's got Cage Williams overthrown. And Malcolm Watkins probably should have picked that one off, but I guess he just didn't understand that the ball was going right to him.
I'm going to tell you what I think happened. I think he got distracted by the official.
Back judge. Yep.
Yes.
Yeah, I think so,
too. I don't know if he found that ball until it was too late.
So that's a fortunate mistake that goes in the favor of the Rams, because that should have been picked off. And he would have had a lot of real estate in front of him. An eligible man downfield called against the Rams, but that play is declined. Remain fourth down, and Cage Williams will be back to punt again for the Rams for the fourth time this evening in the first half. 5:05 left here in the first quarter. The Rams trail Frontier 21-7. Williams, short punt, lands at the 50, goes out about the 48, so the Titans will start just shy of midfield. Defense has got a hold here, Coach. Defense has got a hold.
Absolutely, absolutely. Got a hold. Like to get the ball back with some time to try to move it, but definitely have to keep Frontier out of the end zone on this particular drive. Well, in all drives, but.
Fortunate. Fortunate ball placement for the Rams, because I thought that ball went out at the 48. They're placing it at the 45, so that's a three-yard gimme.
Yes.
So Titans offense that's been playing quite well. That 54-yard touchdown run by Kayas. I apologize. And that one will stick around right around the line of scrimmage, maybe get about 2 yards there for number 32. Kayas again.
Very good job by the run defense, and sets up a situation that Frontier might come out and throw the ball. We have to do what we can to make sure that we hold them to little or very little or no gain to set up a third down.
Bryson Tablet, one of the fastest guys on the central section of the backfield now for the Titans, and he will take the handoff right at the 48, but he's met right around the 45-yard line after about 2 yards. So a nice stop there by the Rams defense to get him. And we're right at the 50, so 2 yards, so that make it third and 5. Bryson Tablet, one of the best 100-yard sprinters we have in the central section. Made it to state last year. Very, very quick. But an empty backfield. Trips to the top half of your screen. Twins down here to the bottom half. Statler all alone in the backfield. Rams look to pressure. Quick out. Fires. Finds his receiver. And again, that is Taylor Ramirez, number 10. And that is another first down for the Titans. So Statler very quick with those passes. And a 20-yard on the dot pass there.
Drug down by number 21. Bryce Hansen, Frontier first down.
Take it down to the 30-yard line, first and 10 for the Titans, 3:28 and counting. So they're in good position to score again. And the Rams need to figure out a way to get to Statler like they did on that opening series and get the ball back and either not allow Frontier to score or get the ball back and score again. The last thing you want to do is be down by 3 touchdowns going into the half.
Absolutely. We get the ball to start the second half, but being down by just 2 scores is obviously better than being down by 3.
And there's Tablet one more time. He shakes off the first defender, but is finally wrapped up and snarled down by Logan Slayton. We're going to have some halftime festivities, and we're going to keep We're going to keep the noise going for you because we want you to hear all the skits at halftime tonight. It's going to be a lot of fun. You're going to enjoy it. And I'm sorry you're going to have to listen to my voice on that as well, ladies and gentlemen. But we will keep that going for you. For those at home that want to watch these the halftime festivities, we will keep that going for you right here on GMSN. So second and three from the 23 for the Titans. Tablet goes from the right to the left. Statler drops back. He's got pressure. He fires way out of bounds. And we got some ladies down here on the grass that didn't even know that that ball was almost going to hit him right in the head. Ma'am, if you look up from your computer every now and then, you realize there's a pretty entertaining football game going on. Oh, that's Debbie Stapp doing her homework because she's in a master's program. Debbie Stapp, get off your phone. Get off your computer, Debbie. Her husband, Ron Stapp, the Californian reporter, goes over and goes, honey, you almost got decapitated by a football. You're a grandma of five, Debbie. They want you around a little bit longer.
Big down.
Big down. So third and three from the 23-yard line for the Rams. 2:15 left here in the first half. Titans with the ball up 21-7. Again, Statler under center. Is he going to roll out? Is he going to hand it off? He does. And it's on a swing pass. And nice stop there. That was Ginyu with the run there for the Titans. And he is stopped behind the line of scrimmage. So that's going to force a fourth down. So Song Ginyu.
And that's Jonathan Lester on that tackle, I believe.
And we do have a player down on the field. Can't see if it's one of ours or not. I believe it is a Ram down on the field. Or maybe it is a – no, it is a Frontier Titan on the ground. Can't see the number, so we'll have a little break in action here, but that will force a fourth down.
Really nice defensive play by Jonathan Lester.
I agree, Coach.
Every game you're going to hear his name a lot. One of a whole lot of great individuals on this team. Number 23, is that correct?
No, you just. Okay, so that is Ngsong Ginyu, who was injured on the play. He is up on his own power and is walking off. So we do have fourth and three, even though the down marker on the field doesn't indicate it. It will be a fourth down. And it looks like the Titans are going to go for it with 1:56 and counting left here. Bradley Horton, how are you, Bubba? So the Titans are going to go for the ball here, up by two scores. Double motion here. Landon Hariri in the backfield for blocking purposes, and that ball just will go.
Wow.
And a completion to Malcolm Watson, and he's going to walk into the end zone. So fourth and three from the 23-yard line. And quickly, a 27-7 lead, and that Frontier offense is rolling right now, Coach.
We'll have 1:31 left in the half. Goes without saying, we have to do what we can to try to get the ball, get some points on the board before halftime.
Now, we will get two starters back in the second half, and that will be Ian Harrison and Luke Taylor that will be able to play in the second half after having to sit the first half for undisclosed reasons. We do have Michael Smith, the sophomore wide receiver DB, who was out tonight because of concussion protocol. But hopefully in the second half, the Rams can get something going because they'll need it. We've got 1:31 and two timeouts left for the Rams, but they do trail 28-7 here in the first half against a very potent.
What year is Ian Harrison?
What, Coach?
What year is Ian Harrison?
So the Rams will receive the ball here. 1:31 left here in the first half, trailing Frontier 28-7 here on homecoming. Right after the final whistle of this first half, we will start our halftime festivities. Will be fun and will be very enjoyable. We saw the skits yesterday at the rally in the gym, and very well done, very well orchestrated. Every night, Our advisors have been there with each class. They've been in the quad in the gym, out here on the field, getting ready for tonight's festivities, and we're going to crown our homecoming king and queen. So tonight will be an enjoyable evening for all. And the punt is away, and it looks like it's going to be Nate Wallace at the 9-yard line. He'll take that. He's got Cage Williams with a block in front of him, and Nate will take that up to about the 25-yard line, and that's where the Rams will start. We got a little extracurricular activity between Lawrence Wallace and David Aguilera. I believe that there was a flag on the play on that one. That's probably going to be double unsportsmanlike. So unsportsmanlike conduct against the Rams. Are you going to call an unsportsmanlike against the Frontier Titans? You are not. So that's going to drop the Rams probably back to either the 12 or the 13-yard line, depending. So unfortunate situation for the Rams there. That'll drive them all the way back to the 14-yard line. Oh, we see Titan Tom walking up. How you doing, buddy?
So I'm going to do all the halftime festivity stuff that will come in at the end of halftime.
Gola drops back looking, fires off to Austin Hernandez, who picks it up, gets up to the 20. Yeah, right around the 20-yard line, so about a 7-yard gain up to the, about 8-yard gain up to the 22, but the chalk is, is that a quick timeout by, nope. And
about 7-8.
Yep.
Over the middle.
Sorry, by seven. Thought the clock was going to either stop there. So second and 3, 8 yards there. Rams got to get the ball off here quickly. Fires off, and that will stop. That will be a first down out to Hansen.
And he got out of bounds, so it stops the clock.
And he did get out of bounds, so regardless, the clock was going to stop while the chain stopped, but that does help a little bit because he did get out of bounds. Ball goes up to the 29-yard line, so 7-yard pass play there from Gola to Hansen.
And the Rams still have 2 timeouts left. So
37 seconds left that he did not get out of bounds, Coach. So that clock is still turning, still 2 timeouts. Gola looks, fires. He's got Cage Williams out there. Can he get underneath it? Just overthrows him. Great coverage there by Sean Franklin on the incompletion. That'll make it 26 seconds left, 2nd and 10 here in the first half. Rams needing to get on the board here.
The right side deep for number 6, Cage Williams, just past his fingertips. That'll bring up Garza's 2nd down.
I don't see number 13.
That's Will Froelich.
Oh, okay, got it.
So the ball at the 29-yard line, 2nd and 9 for the Rams. Gola fakes, looks, fires. He's got Will Froelich right around the 48-yard line. That's got to be a quick timeout, and that's what they call. So Will Froelich's first catch. We talked about his brother, his twin brother a lot this season.
Holding.
But there is a holding against the Rams, and that will bring it back. Unfortunate situation for Mr. Froelich. His first varsity catch goes for naught.
Gunter was very close to being over the line of scrimmage when he threw the ball.
He was. So that'll make it 3rd and 19 from the 20 with just 17 seconds left here. 2 timeouts, but it's going to make it very difficult to really kind of do anything, especially the way that they've been unable to move the ball. So do you down the ball here, Coach, and just go into the half? Or do you try to fire it and see what you can do?
Well, you know.
I mean, they're playing pre-vet defense right now.
Yes.
So the Rams are going to run it. That's Hernandez. We'll take it up to about the 29-yard line. A 9-yard run there by Hernandez.
I think they'll just let the clock go.
But that'll do it, ladies and gentlemen. So we're going to take the halftime break. 28-7 Frontier. Stick around. Halftime festivities. It's going to be fun.
In continuation of a recent tradition, the students from each class will be performing a skit, which is inspired by our Happy Hoco Holidays theme. Please take your seats as we prepare to turn off the stadium lights. Come and join our freshman class and celebrate the 4th of July with hot dogs, hamburgers, and fireworks. And courtesy of the red, white, and blue, Uncle Sam fights for the freedom to nod our heads and move our hips to the music. So let's ignite the lights and let them shine. It's going to be a party in the USA because Independence Day is every day. So put your hands in the air for the freshman class of 2027. Luckily, Cupid's power love saves the day.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see. V is very, very extraordinary. E is even more than anyone that you adore.
Making my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass and I'm homebound. And I need you, and I miss you.
Yeah.
and girls, gather around for a heartwarming holiday spectacular like none other. As a heartfelt tribute to the true essentials of Christmas, we've thoughtfully set up a nativity scene to oversee our festivities as we embrace the joyful and playful aspects of the holiday season. Now prepare to be transported to a magical world where the North Pole meets the Wild West. You'll witness the jolly guards of Santa Claus, his merry band of elves, and their delightful holiday preparations. But beware, as the mischievous Frontier Grinch has set his sights on causing chaos in that winter wonderland. In a clash of good versus Grinch, watch as the spirit of battle unfolds on the snowy field. Will the naughty Frontier Grinch prevail, or will the heartwarming spirit of the guardsman Santa triumph in the end? Get ready to be entertained and enchanted as we present you this unforgettable holiday performance. Merry Christmas for the class of 2025.
Tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., Santa's coming to town.
Santa! Oh, my God!
Santa Claus is coming to town. You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list and checking it twice. Gonna buy. Santa Claus coming to town, oh yeah! Santa Claus coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Best way to spread Christmas cheer is singing loud for all to hear.
Hate, 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 hate. Double hate.
Loathe entirely.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black beak.
Shadows and the monsters' haunting growls echoed with fright as Sam and Pam wandered through the bone-chilling graveyard. They discovered an abandoned house filled with bloodthirsty vampires and malicious monsters. The veil between the living and the supernatural grows thin, allowing creatures of the night to emerge from their hiding places. It would take an act of four courageous heroes to put an end to this madness. Will Sam and Pam make it out alive? The class of 2024 will have you fighting for your lives through this thriller night. I ain't afraid of no ghosts, are you?
Thank you. Come on now.
Freshman Prince, Bryce Hansen, and Princess Michelle Anton Giovanni. A round of applause for sophomore Prince Gunter Gola and Princess Olivia Garcia. And a big round of applause for junior Prince Logan Slayton and Princess Bella Chavez. Now we will take a moment to reintroduce our senior homecoming court nominees before we announce the king and queen. In the first car, Michael Benign and Jocelyn Sala. In the second car, Caden Towery and Gemma Eddy. In the third car, that beautiful Mustang, Isaiah Crisco and Stella Holland. And finally, coming up in the rear, Kagan McCarthy and Jade Jameson. One more time, our homecoming court, Michael Benines, Jocelyn Sala, Caden Towery, Gemma Eddy, Isaiah Crisco, Stella Holland, Kagan McCarthy, and Jay Jameson. And ladies and gentlemen, our Garces Memorial 2023 homecoming king and queen are Isaiah Crisco and Stella Holland. Congratulations, Isaiah and Stella, and all of our other wonderful homecoming court members. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our homecoming halftime performance. Congratulations to all of our homecoming court, and a big, big thank you to all of our students and class advisors for all of your hard work. The skit judges will deliberate, and we will announce the winners of the skits during the third quarter. Thank you, and enjoy the second half.
Well, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, Garces Memorial Sportsnet here on the Garces Athletic YouTube channel. If you haven't heard my voice enough, I apologize because you're going to hear it some more. I'm Trevor Horn, the Sports Information Director here at Garces Memorial High School. We have a special guest, the one, the only, Titan Tom.
Hey, great to
Tom
be
Myers
here on the broadcast with you.
Hi, buddy.
Evening.
How are you?
I'm doing good,
busy, man.
Busy, man.
Thanks for coming up tonight.
I was up at BC calling the volleyball, broadcasting the volleyball game up there, and then I raced out of there to get here.
So if you guys don't know Tom, he is not only the voice of the Frontier Titans in all aspects, he is also the voice of the Renegades on Saturdays over at Memorial Stadium. So he's a busy man, busy man. Tom, I mean, you've seen Frontier as much as anybody else. Is this pretty indicative of what we see out of them on a week-to-week basis?
Well, I would hazard a guess that I didn't see the first quarter, but I'm guessing that Garces probably scored early.
We did. It was a
and then
fumble.
And then what Frontier does is they make adjustments, and then they come out like a juggernaut and a hurricane on fire and kind of start imposing their will, and they have the ability to do that because their front offensive line, the average on that front offensive line is over 290. So, and it's got a lot of young talent on it, as well as some veteran leadership in Eric De La Garza. And I mean, they just really are, they're a hard team to follow. I mean, they really are.
Very fun team to watch too. So they've done some damage against the Rams today. Tonight is a 28-7 frontier lead. And like we talked about earlier in the broadcast, ladies and gentlemen, Ian Harrison back and returned that kickoff for the Rams. And we did not see him in the first half. He was suspended. He is back in action, and we'll see if that changes anything.
Harrison should make a difference in the second half, and they're going to be relying on Logan Slayton and Gunnar Gola to really start getting that offense moving.
The Rams with Gunnar Gola will have to be able to pass the ball a lot better if they want to keep up and get and crack into this 21-point deficit. Well, Tom, I appreciate it. I know you're a busy man. I thank you. I wanted you to have you on this broadcast. We talked about it last Saturday.
Absolutely.
Appreciate it, man.
Yeah.
And I'll see
happy
you
homecoming to all you guys here at Garces, yep. And good luck for the rest of the game.
Appreciate it.
All
thank
right,
you,
man.
Sir. All right, take care, Tom. Thank you, sir. And we'll bring back the one, the only, John Fanucci back onto the broadcast. Logan Slayton with the run there. Very short gain up to the 30-yard line. 2 yards there for Logan, and that will make it 2nd and 8. And
there's that next sandwich if you want to give it to him.
All right, so 2nd and 8 at the 30-yard line. The Rams really got to start getting those big plays going if they want to crack into this 21-point deficit right now. And Gola pitches it out to Hernandez. Hernandez quickly taken out of bounds after maybe a 2-yard gain.
You know, I know this, again, it seems a very simple thing I'm saying, but we have to start stringing together some first downs. We have to move the ball. Obviously, we got to put the ball in the end zone, but we have to do that in incremental pieces, if you will.
Hernandez has been the workhorse for the Rams, 33 yards on 8 carries. Thanks, Coach. It's not like I haven't been talking for the last 2 hours straight.
I know. Great job at halftime.
I appreciate it. It's a lot of fun. I do really do appreciate doing that. These kids spend so much time. The advisors spend so much time. The parents put so much effort into making these homecoming skits as great as possible. And they were phenomenal.
They were
the
phenomenal.
The seniors with that Ghostbusters at the end. I mean, they really great performance. That Flying Eagle for the sophomores, that was a lot of fun. That's Gola fires, and he's got a intended receiver that is Jack Froelich. And that falls incomplete, so that will 4th and 6, and that's not the way the Rams wanted to start this opening drive of the third quarter as a 3-and-out.
Well, and I know I keep saying it's the little things, but on defense we have to get some stops. Maybe get some turnovers. We have to – I'm not trying to tell anybody what to do, but we have to get pressure on the quarterback.
Cage Williams takes the snap, fires that punt all the way to the 40, and that's going to be a good Garces roll. Past the 30, almost down to the – stopped right at the 25-yard line. So,
okay, Rams, let's get a turnover here.
Yep, so that's a favorable field position for the Garces defense in hopes that they can do some damage here and keep the Titans from scoring.
The Garces kick. Touchdown.
All right, Titans will start this drive off at the 25-yard line, 1st and 10, 10:53 left here in the third quarter. Frontier with a 28-7 lead over the Rams. Bunch formation now for the Titans, just one split out here, and that's Kobe Watson out here to the bottom half of your screen. Statler drops back, looks, fires quickly, and he has got an open receiver one more time, Taylen Ramirez.
Attention Garces students, all skateboards and props must be returned to the ASB room to be considered.
That ball gets out to the 40-yard line, a 15-yard reception there.
Skateboards and props must be returned to the
It's early in the third quarter. I don't think we're going to see a conservative Frontier High School. I think they're going to continue to try to keep the pressure on. The Rams need, we need to stop right here.
Wholeheartedly agree there, Coach. 15-yard pass play there from Statler to Ramirez. Make a 1st and 10 at their own 40. Statler now up to 129 yards passing. Nothing big. Longest pass thus far is 23 yards is that touchdown to Watkins in the second quarter. under center one more time, drops back, fires, looking for a receiver. Harrison there, good defense there by the senior.
Very good coverage.
That was getting you one more time on the the intended receiver there for the Titans. But Harrison obviously missed in the first half on defense. So in the backfields here in the secondary for the Rams, you see Cage Williams, Harrison, Jack Frolick, Nate Wallace, and the freshman Bryce Hansen. Front six, it's got to put a little bit more pressure on Statler. Second and 10, 10 minutes left here. Third quarter, fires.
Great job.
Finds a receiver, but quickly wrapped up right at the 46-yard line.
Really nice tackle by Harrison.
Drug down by number one, Ian Harrison, with an assist by 27, Hogan Slater.
I know I keep saying this, Trevor. I apologize for repeating myself, but a big third down right here.
Six-yard pass play there for Statler. Our great principal, Noel Leon, helping the cars to get through the track right now. Another pass play there, but that'll be short of the first down. We'll see what the Titans end up doing here. Kai Rodriguez on the reception there. That ball does not get up to...
Really good, really nice tackle by Nathaniel Wallace to stop him for little gain. And the Ram defense has done their job.
Yep. So they get the ball up to the 49-yard line, but that will make it fourth and two, and the Titans are not going to go for it here. They're going to line up to punt. Cage Williams is back to receive for the Rams.
A fake, and they get the first.
Yep. So there it is. Frontier with the fake, and that goes all the way down to the 25-yard line. And I wasn't thinking. I was like, are they going to do it at midfield? They did it at midfield. So a nice little run there by the punter, 18, and he's able to get that ball from the 49 all the way down to the 20. So that was a 31-yard run there. And Frontier will keep the ball and keep this drive going all the way down to the 20. So very unfortunate there for the Rams defense.
Let's see if the defense can rise up again, get a stop. Get the ball back to the offense.
If you are the owner of a white Nissan Armada, please move your vehicle immediately.
Statler drops back. He's got pressure. He's got a fire. He's just going to throw this one out of bounds. Good job on the defense there.
You are blocking the exit gate, and it is being towed.
Nissan Armada is getting towed tonight.
And, you know, and I think there is the strategy. I agree with Coach Gola. Get pressure on these guys. Statler to get – did I say his name right?
Statler
to get that ball, throw that ball early.
Titans getting lined up. 7:55 left here in the third quarter. Still leading 28-7. Statler drops back, looks, fires. He's got a receiver open, but overthrows Malcolm Watson there. So a second in completion here, second straight in completion. Make it third and 10. So the defense coming up strong again here after giving up that long fake punt. He had a receiver deep, but good coverage.
Pretty good coverage by number one, by Harrison. He's since he's come back in the game, he's made a couple of really nice defensive plays. We obviously missed him in the first half, but it's good to have him right now.
Diana Rodriguez, our incredible director here tonight. She does everything for us. It's awesome. She's the best. We go all the way back to our B-Varsity days. Those were good days, weren't they? Yeah, they were. We're having some fun now here. Beautiful Sam Tobias Peel, Trevor Horn along with John Finucci. Third and 10 from the 20-yard line, and there's a whistle. And that's probably going to be a false start against the Titans. Am I wrong? Am I right?
Good. Yes, you're right.
Oh,
I got kind of.
Can you text my wife and tell her that?
I think she knows.
She's a good woman.
Absolutely.
Take care of that baby boy Hudson tonight.
Beautiful family.
I appreciate that,
sir. Beautiful family.
I already told her this morning. I said, hey, I don't know what you have planned tomorrow, but tomorrow's a daddy and dude day. We're going to go to Cherry Acres. We're going to hang out, find a pumpkin, do that stuff. That's a good stuff, right, Coach?
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, the lead in to Thanksgiving, and Thanksgiving is such a special time.
It really is. Third and 15. Back to the action from the Rams 25. The defense trying to hold strong here on this drive after the long fake punt. Statler drops back. Oh, is there a hold there? No, but there is an incompletion. And they're going to call a pass interference on Cage Williams.
Oh, my gosh.
And that's incidental contact at best, ladies and gentlemen. That's a travesty. Oh, sorry. I just don't like that call whatsoever.
No, because
you had a block in the back on the offensive line against Johnny Lester after he scooted in. That was a non-call. But then you call that pass play where they're both looking for the ball. There's no pass interference. Cage had turned his eyes. That's unfortunate.
That's really unfortunate because it was really, really a great coverage. Fortunately for the Rams, it's not an automatic first down in high school, so we're still looking at third down.
Yep, so we got about third and three from the 12.
Please report to the press box. Valerie Dameron, please report to the press box.
Why are they there? Why do I put the signs up, but they're not going to listen? All right, Statler drops back, looks. He's going to keep it. He's to the five, inside the three, and the ball goes out of bounds around the two-yard line. If you guys don't stand up, I think we'll be okay. So Statler runs that ball all the way down to the three-yard line, a nine-yard carry for the quarterback. Just the second time he's rushed the ball, but he's got 23 yards, and now the Titans are looking to punch this one in again and take a huge, almost insurmountable lead. And that's the speedster, Bryson Tablet, down to the one-yard line, so he gets about 2 yards on that. And that'll take the Titans down to the one-yard line. Unless the Rams are able to stop him here, it's going to be very, very tough to try to get back into this game down 35-7. Official timeout. There is a Titan down on the field, so we'll take a quick break and be right back. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen. That was number seven, Brady Durkin. So he's up off of his own power, jogging off. So that's good to see. Happy to see that young man up and going. So we're at the one, second and one now for the Titans, looking to punch it in. And they punch this one in. This is almost insurmountable lead for Frontier with 6 minutes and counting left here in the third quarter. Statler under center. And a nothing.
I believe it's got to be on them because.
Yep. False start against the offense. So
absolutely.
That'll.
5 yards. So
we're second and goal now from the six instead of the one. So favorable, Coach?
Well, certainly better than second and one.
Yeah. So. Yeah, second and goal from the one.
Absolutely.
Yeah, this is a little bit better.
Absolutely.
When you see those down and distance markers laying on the turf, and I got to tell you, if you're looking at the turf right now, yes, it is that green right now. Our maintenance crew, Maranatha, doing a fantastic job doing the winter rye over the last 3 weeks without a home game. Nobody went on the field, and it is beautiful. It is crisp and green and the best field in Kern County, hands down.
And people may argue with me, but the best setting in Kern County.
Oh, great stop there by Logan Slayton, tackling Bryson Tablet behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to make it third and goal. now at the 9-yard line. Woo, doggy. That was a great play.
Absolutely.
So just the only the second negative play for the Titans. Well, third if you count the turnover. So third and goal from the 9 now. So it's a passing play. Empty backfield now for Statler. Good pressure.
And great coverage.
Off balance throw. Great pressure there. Great defense by Bryce Hansen.
See them kick the field goal right now or attempt the field goal, which would put them up by 3 scores.
I mean, the Rams could, in fact, if you think about it, you get touchdown, extra point, that's 24 points. That'll bring up a
fourth down. Well, if you go touchdown, 2 points, touchdown, 2 points, touchdown, 2 points, a 3-point game.
Yep.
I mean, 3-score game. I know that's a tall order.
So the left-footed boot of Ryder Crane Finch lining up now for the 29-yard field goal. 29-yard field goal. 4:47 left here in the third quarter. The lefty lining up. The kick is up, and it looks good. So that will be a 31-7 lead here after the 29-yard field goal with 4:41 left here in the third. The defense did their job as best as they could. They kept him from scoring a touchdown, kept him to a field goal after that fake punt, and we got to say it, not a great pass interference call.
No. The officials have a tough job. There's no question about that. But I think they made a mistake on that one.
Yeah. All right, so the Titans will kick off from their own 40. Ian Harrison and Cage Williams deep for the Rams. A long kickoff return here would be splendid. And Williams will take it right at the 5-yard line. He goes to his right, looks for a crease at the 20. He finds it. He's up to the 30, to the 35. Flag comes out. And that usually means a hold.
A hold or a block in the back, absolutely.
Yep, and that's unfortunate because a great kickoff return by Cage Williams is going to be pulled back probably to about the 32-yard line. A hold against the Rams. Depending on where that foul was spotted, that's going to pull that back from almost midfield, probably back to, they're going back to the 25. Nope, they're going to keep it right at the 30-yard line. So what should have been a 40-yard kick return turns into a 25-yard gain. Gujagola, just 4 of 10 for 45 yards passing. You want to get back into this one. You want to make this one a little bit more competitive. You got to throw the ball here.
Absolutely.
All right, so quads to the left on the top half of your screen. Totally empty here on the bottom half. Hernandez in the backfield with Gola. Let's go, Rams. Frolick in motion. Gola keeps it. 35 to the 40. Brought down. Nice open field tackle by Sean Franklin. So Gola gets about 8 yards up to the 38-yard line. Let's make it second and 2. Nice run there by the sophomore quarterback.
And again, a nice read.
Sophomore, I mean, it was Prince, if
it,
I should.
Yeah, it's option all the way, and certainly made the right decision there.
So we're going to give him 9 yards at, make it second and 1 from the 39 is where the ball is spotted past the 38. Feed nerds out there like me. Pressure coming on the backside. He fires. Completed pass. Can't see who that is. Ian Harrison, his first catch tonight. That'll be a first down, and that ball will go up to the 44-yard line. 5-yard pass play. That'll be a first down to the 44. So Rams just need to make this game entertaining from here on out in the final 15 minutes. Goal line, the shotgun with Hernandez in the backfield again. Hernandez thinks about going out in motion, stays in the backfield. Golo looks, drops. He's got Cage Williams out there. Just overthrows him in double coverage. Incomplete. Good idea. Good idea there to go for it there.
Nice coverage also by Frontier. And but again, a great attempt by Gunter. And was that Cage?
That was Cage. Yep. So the undefeated Frontier Titans proving that they are a very formidable foe here this season, not only in the River League, but in the Central Section, seventh ranked in overall in the section, which also means they're the seventh seed in D1 as it speaks right now. Good team. They got Centennial and Liberty coming up in the next couple weeks. Hernandez now, there's that burst of speed, great pursuit there by the Frontier defense, and he's brought down after just about 2 yards. He had a head full of steam there, but he was met by a couple Titans that just stalled him out right away. James Moon and Song Ginju once again there. Nice tackle, just 1 yard there for 2 yards there to the 46 for Hernandez. He's doing work, 9 carries, but just 35 yards. So 2nd and 8 from the 46, 2:33 left here in the third quarter. Rams got to get something going here. An explosive play would be perfect right here. Gola empty. Fires, finds Harrison. Great first down. He splits the defense down to the 25, to the 23. Longest play of the night for the Rams, and that gets him right near the red zone, down to the 22-yard line.
And a well-thrown ball, because Harrison certainly had a lot of attention around him, and Gunter fit it right in there. It's a wonderful pass and a great catch.
31 yards there on that pass play from Gola to Harrison. Takes it all the way down to the 22-yard line, and the Rams are looking. And a quick out to Harrison. This will be a run for him. He gets the ball past the 20, probably down to the 19. Again, another backwards pass from Gola to Harrison.
We'll have to see the flag. Might be a horse collar. I mean,
either a legal man downfield on the Rams or a horse call against the Titans. Holding against the Rams, and so that'll negate that play. And then we'll drop him back to about the 32-yard line, if that is a 10-yard. Okay, so that negates the short run there, and that'll bring the Rams back to the 27-yard line.
First down, let's get half of it back on this play.
First and 15, yes, Coach. Yeah. You know it. Gola passes it out to Nate Wallace. Nice cut there. Another cut, but wrapped up right near the original line of scrimmage. And that's every flag in the book is going to come out. When you do something like that and you throw the ball halfway down the field, it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Yeah. Every day of the week, Coach. So Nate Wallace there. It's about a 5-yard run there for Wallace.
Flag after the play. Ruled to be.
So we're looking at maybe.
By Frontier.
Well, it won't be delay a game. I think it'll be unsportsmanlike conduct.
Oh, it's 100% unsportsmanlike conduct. And there goes Gino Lefevre going to get the ball like a good man he is. Because you can't play football without a football. So my daddy told me one time.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So wait for the call. Unsportsmanlike conduct against the defense. Another unsportsmanlike conduct. That one is called off, so that ball will take it down to the 25-yard line. So here goes the Rams.
Correction, there was 2 dead ball fouls.
They offset. So I'll make it
they appear to offset.
2nd and 12 from the 27. So they will offset. So no harm, no foul on that. And a little acting job there by Edgar Cueva, but that should be encroachment on the Titans.
Now, again, I'm not being critical of the officials, but if it's a delay a game, isn't that an automatic dead ball foul? Doesn't the play stop right there?
It should have, right?
You would think.
You'd think. But what do we know? You don't coach anymore, and I'm just a blowhard. Second and 7 from the 20-yard line now for the Rams. Hands it off to Hernandez. He breaks up. Oh, breaks a tackle. Great spin move there all the way up to the 10-yard line. So a nice run there by Hernandez. Gets 10 yards on that play, and there's a little extracurricular going on again. So we're getting a little chippiness going on, Coach.
Well, and I think it was either a face mask or an unsportsmanlike conduct.
So 10 yards there for Hernandez, his longest run of the night. Another personal foul against the Titans.
Boy, you know,
that'll push the Rams all the way down to the 5-yard line.
Absolutely. And it's so important right now, Trevor, that the Rams keep their cool. Because if you do anything to get yourself ejected from a game, then you're going to not be able to play next week against them. Bakersfield Christian, and again, another very important game for us.
Very much so. Golo with Slayton in the backfield. Rams looking to punch this one in, down 31-7. 22 seconds left here in the third quarter. Slayton with the ball. Rumbles, stumbles, stopped at the 1-yard line. That should be the final play here of the third quarter. 4 yards for Slayton. And we're going to flip the script and take it all the way to the north end zone. Frontier leads 31-7. It's end of the third quarter. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back. All right, we're back for the start of the fourth quarter here on GMSN on the Garces Athletics YouTube channel. I'm Trevor Horn. Thank our title sponsor, SCOE, Southern California Orthopedic Institute, and our other sponsor, Sean McNally, Clearu Tires, Jean Quinto, Ortho Arts, and Mission Bank. Thank you for your continued support. And there it is. It's announced. The seniors have won the homecoming skit. And I think we all saw that one coming, didn't we, Coach?
Well, you know, I mean, I don't know if the viewers had a chance to watch it.
They did.
But it was simply outstanding from the props to the coordination to the presentation to everything.
It was pretty awesome. All right, so the Rams second and goal from the 2-yard line, looking to punch it in, trying to get the second score of the game after scoring on that opening drive, and then nothing since then. Hernandez in the backfield with Gola. Bunch formation. Hernandez takes it. He's stopped. About the 1-yard line. And that's where third down will be.
We've obviously got two downs and
just 1 yard.
And 1 yard.
So Hernandez is going to stay in at running back.
Inches a little closer.
Third and goal for the Rams, down 31-7 with 11:29 left and counting in this one. Gola in the offense, looking for a little spark here. Hernandez punches it in. Touchdown!
Good job.
Garces, 1-yard touchdown run for Austin Hernandez. And with 11:11 left in the fourth quarter, 11:11 left here in the fourth quarter,
If I'm doing my
Rams
math,
cut
you
it
go
in.
For two.
Yep.
You need, obviously, three touchdowns and 3 2-point conversions to tie the game because you're down by 24 before the score.
So the offense does stay out, just like Coach said. Trips to the left for Gola. Hernandez in the backfield. 31-13, they're trying to make this one 31-15, and that makes it a two-score game.
Absolutely.
And there is Hernandez with a two-point conversion.
And that, you know,
and makes it 31-15. That's a big conversion there, Coach.
You know, and I hesitated to say it, but what I was going to say is I think you run the option down here because Gunter runs the ball so well.
Yep.
And if he pitches it to Hernandez, then Hernandez is open.
Yep. Couldn't agree with you more, Coach.
So do you onside kick here with 11-11 left, or do you say, defense, we're going to put it on you a little bit?
I put it on the defense.
I would,
go.
Too. 11-11's a little early.
It is. And it's only a two-score game.
Absolutely.
As insurmountable as it felt there for a little bit.
Absolutely.
It's still now.
We're within 16 points.
Yeah, it's two scores.
Absolutely.
Do that two more times, and the ball is. So I would not.
I agree.
I mean, you've won 157 more games than I have as a head coach.
You know, I just think here.
So you're the smart
your
one.
Defense hasn't at times played that badly. So
and there's a pooch kick right to
absolutely.
The 32
let's
quickly
make,
wrapped
make
up
a
by Ricky Johnson.
Great tackle
yep,
by
right
Ricky Johnson.
Right at the 33-yard line, and that's not bad.
Absolutely not.
I'm okay with that field position at the 33.
Absolutely not. If you kick it deep, yep. You give them the chance to did what they did with the kickoff.
And again, after that 23-yard touchdown to Malcolm Watson, Malachi Statler is just 3 of 7 since then. For
absolutely.
22 yards,
absolutely.
And he's thrown 3 consecutive incompletions. So the defense is doing a good job against them. They just
defense
need to stop
did a good
them.
Job to open the half.
Yeah. You know what the Rams could use right now?
A turnover.
Yes, 100%. So here we go. Kobe Watson in motion. Statler drops back. He's pressured on the backside, but he finds Watson, who was in motion.
4-yard game.
Yeah.
5
to the 37-yard line. 4-yard gain. To the 38, yep. Second and 6. 142 yards passing for Statler, far below his average of about 300 yards thus far. Oh, Statler finally
Wonderful
wrapped
job.
Up, and there's Nick Hernandez jumping on his back, and that's a sack.
I think the initial pressure was by RJ.
Yep.
Oh, by Logan.
Logan Slayton. So that's a 5-yard loss. I'll make a 3rd and 11. So the
and
defense.
A big 3rd and 11.
A big 3rd and 11. So you get that same pressure, and Statler gets that ball off. If you've got your DBs hawking the ball, they might be able to pull this one off and get that ball back and we might have a whole different ball game
Absolutely.
Here, Coach.
Absolutely. You know, we were looking at 31-7. It was looking bleak. If we get a stop now, get our offense back on the field.
Score quickly.
Absolutely.
We got a ball game. Because especially if you score and get the two-point conversion.
Absolutely. Then you're within one score.
Correct. So 3rd and 11 from their own 33-yard line. 10:06 and counting. Oh, a handoff to Tablet,
oh,
and
wow.
He finds that speed and gets a first down to midfield, and that's
wow.
A great play call there.
That is. I'm sure we were thinking pressure on Statler because he's probably going to throw the football.
Yep. Longest run play for the Titans since that 54-yard scamper.
Yes.
So Tablet showing his speed and does his job and gets him to midfield, and that extends this drive when the Rams look like they could stop him here. Statler fires, finds receiver, breaks 2 tackles, finally brought down by Logan Slayton, Austin Tapia there.
Statler's pass complete to number 14, Austin Tapia.
And that's another first down, down to the 34-yard line, 16 yards there on the pass play.
That's a pretty impressive defensive play by Logan Slayton because you're talking about the guy comes out of the linebacker position and makes a tackle on the sideline. That's great hustle.
That's a guy that wants to play at the next level.
Absolutely.
And has all the intangibles to do it.
Absolutely.
All right, Statler again in the backfield. Shotgun formation. Motion. Hands off. And that's Caius. And he gets that ball down to the 26-yard line. So the defense.
Nice tackle by Luke Taylor.
Yep, looking good there for a second, and now they're getting a little pressure there.
Tries up the middle, brought down by number 4, Ricky Johnson, and 16, Luke Taylor.
7 yards there.
Brings up a frontier second down.
Second and 3 from the Garces 27. Rams defense, again, definitely needs a.
Definitely needs a turnover. Absolutely right.
Under center again. Statler hands it off. Ooh, great stop there. Initial stop by the man, the myth, the legend, Logan Slayton.
Boy, I'll tell you what, he's played an outstanding defensive game tonight.
He really is.
Outstanding, he has.
3-yard loss makes it 3rd and 6. Eli. Oh, Miggy, sorry. All right, 3rd and 6 from the Rams, 30, 7:42 and counting left here in this one.
Empty backfield, so I think we need to bring some pressure right now. Get some pressure on number 13.
So Tablet goes out. Ginyu comes in. Durkin's in motion. Statler looks, fires. He's got a receiver open. And that is a touchdown, the aforementioned Ginyu. 30-yard touchdown play for the Titans. And that might
I'll tell you, a very nice play by Statler because Coach Gola brought pressure. He knew that he was going to get hit,
yep.
And he hung in there. He threw
a
beautiful pass.
He just threw a nice little lofter right over the defense where only his receiver could get it. Actually had to come in just about a yard. And I think that's going to do it, Coach. So 7:18 left here, and Rams look like they could probably get back into this one. And then the long run by Tablet on 3rd and short. On 3rd and long, excuse me. Extended that drive to midfield. And that left boot is good. Hits the kettle corn. 38-15 now. And right now the Rams are just playing for pride in this one and going to gear up for Bakersfield Christian next week.
Well, that's what I was going to say. Not only are they playing for pride, but they're playing for next week because what Coach Gold is looking for right now is are we willing to hang in there and fight, you know, even in a situation like this.
Bakersfield Christian was victorious tonight against a 1-6 Ridgeview team, 49-7. Centennial leads Highland with 7 minutes left in the fourth quarter, 24-0. And then we saw what Liberty did against Stockdale in a 56-6 win. So those are your River League and our cross rival scores.
Yes.
BCHS winning that Valley League game tonight. So a big win for the Eagles. They'll have a large head of steam going into next Saturday's game, which is also going to be the homecoming, I believe, for BCHS. So kick is going to go all the way down, and Cage Williams is going to pick it up at the 1 yard line, breaks a tackle, keeps going about the 20 up to the 22 yard line, and that's where the Rams will start this drive. But with 7:10 left here in the game, Frontier leads 38-15. I think it's easy to say that this one's over.
Well, you know, 23 points in 7 minutes and 10 seconds, you know, that's a lot to ask for.
But I mean, basically what you have to do is you have to score onside, score onside, score onside, because you can't give the ball back to the Frontier offense the way that they've been driving all night long.
Absolutely. Right. And there will come a time in the game you would think where they would simply say, we'll do things that might be a little bit more conservative. They throw the ball well, but they could shorten up their passes, get completions, and keep the clock running. So that's why To keep the ball out of their hands is important.
But we haven't talked about this on the broadcast yet. But one thing to bring up now, ladies and gentlemen, is a win tonight for the Rams likely would have put them in the Division I playoffs, regardless of what happens the rest of the season going out, because that would have been such a big win. As Ian Harrison takes the handoff, and he's going about 8 yards on that one, so a nice little run there by Harrison. But this loss will likely Centennial, Bakersfield Christian, and Stockdale all ranked below the Rams. As of right now, we'll see how this loss affects them compared to Bakersfield Christian. But nothing there is a major upset win if the Rams win out the final three games and go 5-5. And that will put them in the Division II playoffs for the first time in this new format, where the Rams have gone Division I the past 2 years and then lost in the first round at San Joaquin Memorial 2 years ago and then Clovis High last year. So that was a first down for Harrison, 10 yards there on the run. The Rams at the 33-yard line and an incompletion there by Gola. And I think we have to really talk about that, because I think that's such a benefit for this program, because when you think about it, think about the other teams that are in Division I. They're all big public schools. You know, the Central section is so much different than the Southern section, where the private schools rule the roost down in the Southern section. We don't rule the roost here. We don't have the population to pull from like they do down south.
Well, so especially when you get to the Clovis area, too.
Yeah. Because the Clovis Unified does such a great job with their student body that it's one of those things where, you know, you really do have to you got to stay up with the Joneses, and with 35 guys on the roster, we can't compete with schools that have 50, 60 guys on the team with a student body of 30. As Gola keeps the ball. Ooh, nice little break there on that first tackle, and he's going. I mean, Guter Gola is, for a guy that's just 12 months from knee surgery, really does not play like a guy that had knee surgery 12 months ago.
No, he doesn't. And every snap he takes in every game, he matures that much more.
And every snappy sorry. Just started thinking of the Police. But you are right. He is a very heady, a very mature sophomore, very mature football player. So third and about four here for the Rams. Bunch formation. 5:55 left in this one. 38-15 Frontier lead. Hernandez in the backfield. Gola fires and finds the freshman, Bryce Hansen, for the first down to the 45 after the 8-yard carry. That'll make a first down. Bryce Hansen, nice catch there for 8 yards. His third catch tonight. He's been the top target for Gola this evening. So first and 10 at their own 45. They're going up in hurry up, trying to get another score on the board here. Hernandez in the backfield. Gola looks, fires, looking for Hansen, but he was double coverage there. It was Landon Heredier there on the coverage to knock the ball away. Second and 5. 88 yards passing now for Gola compared to 190 for Statler. But still, again, just like kind of what you saw the defense do last week, you know, Liberty had some big plays, but overall, you know, it's one of those things where
yeah, you know, and like Coach Gola said, he's still waiting to put that full game together.
I think Thousand Oaks was very, very close.
Uh-huh. I absolutely
Menachie, yes, but that was an inferior opponent. But that Thousand Oaks win was big. Hopefully we can get back to that. As Gola looks, fires, finds Cage Williams at the 40 for about a 15-yard gain there, 16 yards to the 39. First catch night for Cage. Goes for 16 yards. And that'll put Gola.
Cage has a little bit of cramps problem on the field. So.
First and down to the 39 as Cage is down. As he's quickly brought up to his feet and he's going to walk
cramp.
It off.
Yeah.
That's just that. I shouldn't say just a cramp, but that is a cramp. Nothing more. Nothing less.
Let's give number 6, Mr. Williams, a round of applause as he makes his way out.
So after that 16-yard pass play, Cage will come out for just a second as he's tended to. Rams looking to punch it in again, make it a little bit more respectable.
And you want to end on a high note.
You do. You don't want to go in with the tail between your legs.
No, sir.
Yep.
No, absolutely
and
not.
That should be an encroachment on the Titans. Yep. So, 3 yards. Takes it down to the 34, and that'll be a first and 5. Clock has stopped here with 4:59. Festive evening. Lopsided game, fun night. Goal in the backfield with Hernandez. Gola drops, doesn't like what he sees, gets up to about the 35 and taken down right away. Loses about a yard there.
I'll tell you what, I'm very impressed with Frontier's speed on defense.
Yeah.
They
not only pass the eye test, which they do, they're big boys, but they're big and physical. They're gonna do some damage in D1.
Yes.
It's gonna be tough. Clovis North is formidable, top 10 in the state.
Yeah. And we all know what's going on over at Liberty, so.
Yep. That's gonna be a showdown for the ages. Okay. Angola looks, and that whistle blew before the ball came out, so that will be a sack for the Titans. Great pressure there.
Yeah.
By Easton Conley. So I'll make it third and long, third and about 12 from the 41-yard line.
Progress was stopped. Player was being driven backwards. That brings up a third down.
So 6-yard loss there.
Let's get a first down here, Rams. Let's get half of this back on third down and go for that first down on fourth down.
Well, here's a wrinkle we saw last week. It's Nick Gonzalez playing at the H-back, and that ball will fall incomplete. Yeah. A helmet comes off. That's Jake Ruiz on that incompletion. So, Rams, you got to go for it here.
Absolutely.
Nothing to lose. There's 3:10 left in the game.
Absolutely. Yep. Absolutely.
All right, Coach. So you got fourth and a long 11,
well,
short 12.
Well, you're obviously going to throw the ball.
You have to.
It's imperative that the offensive line gives Gunter the time to allow the receivers to get down the field far enough for the first down.
Gunter rolls out to his right, looks, fires, overthrows Nate Wallace, and that'll be a turnover on down for the Rams.
Yes.
And that should about do it.
Yep. Goal is pass. For number 2, Nathaniel Wallace. Ball's incomplete.
An unfortunate end of the night for the Rams as an ineligible.
It is. It is.
Yeah.
It
but
is.
It's unfortunate to lose. It's unfortunate to lose a league game. It's unfortunate to lose on homecoming. However, if you want to look at a silver lining, it is that Division I is almost insurmountable now. It's not going to be the case for the Rams, and so that might actually be, if we're going to look at any silver lining here, is that the Rams will be able to, you know, as long as they get this, you know, they're able to win out and do what's right.
I was going
to
say,
they'll need to win out the final three games against Bakersfield Christian, Centennial, and Stockdale. That's not going to be an easy feat, but it is doable.
Absolutely.
If they're able to do that, a high D2 seed is in the cards for the Rams, and everything can change as the defensive front, led again by Logan Slayton, gets into the backfield here. And so.
And, you know, and the thing is, the next three games, they're playing against probably Division II opponents.
Yeah.
And therefore, every game you're playing is for seeding.
Right. You're playing for seeding. You're playing for wins.
Yep.
You're playing for momentum going into the playoffs.
Absolutely.
Because the playoffs are, I mean, they're 4 weeks away.
Uh-huh.
They're right around the corner.
Yes.
We're in week 8. This is the 7th game of the season. The Rams are going to fall to 2-5, 0-2 in River League. They're going to play a cross-rival game, so next week will not be a league game. At Bakersfield Christian at 7:30 next Saturday. That is a Saturday game, ladies and gentlemen. Just so you know, This is only the second Friday night game. And, oh, that's an acting job there by number 55, Eric De La Garza. And if they call that, that's just ridiculous. Because him and Cage Williams were kind of jostling. And then number 55 for Frontier does a, I mean, hand him the Oscar.
We have to be really careful here. I mean, we have to be really careful because.
I really don't think.
Oh, good. They should. Okay, you wave it off. You wave it off. That's a good wave off.
Yes, I agree.
That flag was waved off.
So 2:03 left here, and the clock is going to keep turning, and this game is going to be over here in just a few.
Rams, let's keep our cool. Let's realize that we don't want to do anything to negatively affect next week.
Yep.
Let's tip our hats to Frontier and get ready for Bakersfield Christian.
Titans go 1-0 in league, and they remain undefeated 7-0. And, you know, you got to think that they're going to start cracking that top five in the Central section. But the Central section is tough in the top five. You're talking about Clovis North, Clovis East, Liberty, Clovis West. I mean, that's
and Clovis. And Clovis.
And Sanger is in there as well. Hanford's a Division I team right now.
Yes.
Central Valley Christian right now is the they're in the top 10, but they're D3 base. So they'll likely be, as long as they win out and don't have a hiccup here.
They'll be the top seed.
They'll be the number one seed in D2. Lemoore is the 2 seed right now in D2.
If people are wondering why Central Valley Christian wouldn't be in D1, you can't move up 2 divisions.
Right. So if you're a D1 base, you can only play D1 or D2. If you're D2 base, you can play D1, D2, or drop to D3. And as you go down D3, the same thing. If you're D3 base, you can
go
only go up
one
to D2
or down one.
Exactly. You can't go up 2 or more or down 2 or more. Like Shafter is in the top 20 in the Central section, but they're D4 base. So they'll be the one seed in D3.
Absolutely.
Because it looks like they're a powerhouse, and they're probably going to run through the SSL the final 4 weeks of the season, the final 3 weeks of the season, because they had a big win last night over Delano. So there's good football being played here in Kern County. Obviously, Liberty is the number one team. Frontier is obviously showing that they are very close to being the number one team as well. That showdown is going to be huge between Liberty and Frontier. Rams defense does their job, but with just 53 seconds here, it'll go for naught as that ball will drop, and Cage will pick it up at the 45, to the 50, to the 40, to the 35, the 30, and he takes that contact, ladies and gentlemen. Goodness gracious. Cage administered that contact with a great punt return. So the Rams will get the ball with 42 seconds left, and maybe here they can punch it in, Coach.
Up the left side. Nice return.
Nice return there by Cage, and shows that, you know.
You know, I'm looking at Cage right now, and I know
he's frustrated.
Plus, I know he just came off of concussion.
Yeah.
And
but what would it be without another flag?
I would be concerned right now. We're hoping it's frustration and not, you know, dizziness.
Right.
Because that was a heck of a collision, and I'm watching Cage right down there, and I don't. And
yeah, I don't like that.
I don't like it either. He seems.
Yep. Okay.
Discombobulated.
So the Rams will start at the Frontier 44-yard line with 42 seconds left here. We'll see if they down it or if they try to punch it in here. As Will Frolick comes in, likely replacing Cage Williams here. Hopefully we get Mike Smith back next week. He'll be a big integral part of this offense and defense and special teams.
I don't mean to alarm anybody, but I hope we have Cage Williams next week.
It doesn't look promising now.
No.
Gola rolls out, fires, finds Will Frolick, and there it is, ladies and gentlemen.
Beautiful.
Will Frolick's first varsity catch.
Will Frolick, you know, his twin brother, we've heard so
Jack,
much about this year. I know Will personally. Well, I know the whole Frolick family personally. But, again, they're all quality young people, and Will is a quality young man.
So the Rams with the ball. The clock is still going. No timeout called here. So this will likely be, unless it's an incomplete pass, or out of bounds, will be the last play of the game. 38-15 Frontier lead. A little confusion here. 8 seconds left. Are they going to get the ball off in time? 5 seconds, 4 seconds. Gola gets it. looks. He's going to have to fire to the end zone, but he's not going to get that ball off. And that's going to do it, ladies and gentlemen. Frontier with a 38-15 victory over the Rams. Rams fall to 2-5, fall out of D1 contention. But that might not be a bad thing, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see how the final 3 weeks go. Congratulations, Frontier Titans. Undefeated still at 7-0, 1-0 in River League action. We will not be broadcasting the road game next week, but we'll be back on October 20th for senior night. Always a fun night against the Centennial Golden Hawks. So for John Finucchi, Diana, Jay, Cooper over there, our president, Kent Hickey, our principal, Noel Leon, our athletic director, Eric Coleman, I'm Trevor Horn. You guys have a wonderful evening. God bless. Drive safe. We'll see you in 2 weeks.